Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PHP on your Windows 11 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install PHP, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar you need to just simply type PHP download, then enter, and then you'll be seeing this www.php.net is basically our first search result. So just, you know, simply click on this download PHP, and this is going to redirect you to this official site of PHP. I'll be also putting this link in the description, so you don't need to worry about the link and all. Right, and here under this current stable PHP 8.0.13, which is released on 18th of November 2021, you can see that we have this Windows download. So since you are downloading it for Windows, so I'll just, you know, simply going to click on this Windows button, and it will, you know, going to show you this page. And here you can see that we have one non-thread safe option and we have a thread safe option. So we are going to download the thread safe option. So just, you know, simply click on this zip, and it will, you know, going to start downloading our PHP. So since we have already downloaded it, I just, you know, simply cancel it. And if I just simply minimize my browser, and if I just simply go to my download directory, you can clearly see that I have already PHP 8.0.13 right downloaded over here. Now to extract, you need to just simply right click on it, and then you need to just simply click on this extract all, and it will, you know, going to ask you that whether you would like to make this path as your extract folder. So just simply keep this default, then just simply click on extract, and it will, you know, going to start extracting. And you can see that it has, you know, rightly extracted, and our folder is also opened over here. So let us first cancel this, and this is our folder, right? So just, you know, simply rename it to a small version, that is PHP 13, 8.0.13, right? So just PHP 8.0.13, and then you need to just simply right click on it, and then you need to just simply click on the show more options, and then you need to just simply cut it, right? And then you need to just simply go to your C drive, then right click on it, and again click on show more options, and then paste. Right, you can see that it has, you know, rightly pasted over here. Now just simply go inside that folder, and then just simply click on this address bar, then right click on it and copy. Right, and then you need to just simply click on this search icon, and here you need to just simply type environ. You'll be getting this edit the system environment variables. So just simply click on that, then click on environment variables, then you need to just simply scroll down a bit, and here you'll be getting this path. So just simply click on path, then edit, and here you need to just simply click on new, then right click on it and paste. So what we are doing is we are going to first download our PHP, then we are going to extract it, and then we are going to copy it in our C drive. Then we need to just simply copy that path, and then we need to paste it in our edit environment variables. So we are setting our environment, right? And then we need to just simply click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK, right? And now let us just minimize this, and if we again simply click on the search icon, and here if you just simply type CMD, then enter, you can see that our command prompt has been rightly opened. And here if you just simply type php space dash dash version, then enter, you can see that latest version of PHP, that is PHP 8.0.13, has been rightly installed on our machine. So in this way you can easily install PHP on your local system, right? So now I'm going to also show you how to run a simple PHP program. So for that, let us first create a new folder over here. So new folder, and let's name it as a PHP dash workspace, right? Then just simply go inside that folder. So we are currently under PHP workspace folder, then right click on it, then new, then text document. So inside this text document, I'm going to write a simple PHP program, say Angular bracket, PHP. If you face any difficulty, I'll just simply, you know, make it a bigger, right? And I'm going to simply echo hello world, right? So that we can test that whether our program is working properly or not. Then just simply go to file, save as, and here you need to give a file name as a prog.php, right? And you need to also click on the save as type to all file type, yeah. And then just simply click on save, and you can clearly see that our file has been rightly saved as prog.php. So just simply minimize it. You can see that this file has been rightly created, prog.php. Just simply click on this address bar once again, then this time just simply type cmd, then enter, and you can see that our command prompt has been rightly opened inside our PHP workspace directory, right? And here if you just simply type php, then your file name, that is prog.php, so prog.php, and then if you just simply hit enter, you can see that hello world has been actually shown in our console. So all this basically mean is our PHP has been actually installed on our machine and our program is also running properly, right? So in this way you can easily install the latest version of PHP on your Windows 11 operating system. But I'll still want to recommend you a popular software called XAMPP. So since PHP is basically a server based language, so it is very important to, you know, use a server where you will be just basically running your PHP programs. So XAMPP is a very popular software which is used to run server related scripts. So it is mainly designed for PHP language. So I have already made a video on XAMPP, so you can watch that video. I'll be putting the link in the description, so you can watch it from there, right? So what it basically will do is, it will, you know, going to create a htdoc folder which we'll be using to communicate with the server, and we'll be creating that server locally so that we can, you know, program any PHP related scripts. We can basically program it there and we can just run it using that htdoc folder, right? So I'll be recommending you to install XAMPP also, right? If you want to, you know, code in PHP, right? So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a like, and so please do share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.